Namaste. Today we will check how to solve equations having the variable on both sides. Both sides means both sides of equal sign. Here it is LHS, that is left hand side of equal, and here it is RHS, right hand side of equal. Now we are going to solve where variables are on both sides of this equal sign, that is on LHS and RHS. Let us do some examples. Solve 2x minus 3 is equal to x plus 2. I have two methods to solve this. Here we have 2x keeping on LHS. Here x plus 2 already in RHS. I am taking this minus 3 from LHS to RHS. Then negative 3 going to RHS. It becomes positive 3. The sign of negative 3 changes when it goes to RHS. Here there is 2x. Here x is there. Now two constants are there, 2 and 3. That you can add. 2 plus 3 is 5. Now you got 2x is equal to x plus 5. I am going to subtract. I need only the value of x. That is the solution. So I am here subtracting 1x from this 2x. I don't want 2x. I need only 1x. So 2x minus x, that I will get 1x. What I am going to do here is subtract x from both sides. Remember, whatever thing you do in LHS, if there is an equal sign, then you have to do it in the RHS. Then only this equality balance. So I am subtracting x from LHS. So I need to subtract x from RHS also. Here 2x minus 1x, simply x means 1x. 2x minus 1x is x, because 2 minus 1 is 1. So 2x minus x is x, is equal to, here positive x and negative x, they are additive inverse. So the result will be 0. This x and this minus x, result is 0. Balance is plus 5 here. Now we got the value of x, that is x is equal to 5. So this is the first method how to find the value of x if in LHS and RHS there is a variable. Now next method is till this. This is the same from the previous method, that is keeping 2x in LHS, taking minus 3 to RHS, it becomes positive 3. Again 2x is equal to x plus 5 that we did in the previous method also. Now transposing method, I am going to change the position of x, that is here it is 2x in LHS. I am taking this x, that is taking every variable to one part and every constants to the other part. So I made first the constant to RHS and it become positive 3. Now I am taking this variable part to LHS. So all the variables will be in the LHS part. Here plus x going to LHS, it becomes minus x. 2x minus x is equal to, here it is 5. Now 2x minus, simply x means 1x. 2x minus 1, that is 2 minus 1 is 1. 1x is equal to 5. 1x means x. Now we got the value, x is equal to 5. So in this whole chapter, I am going to use this method, that is transposing method. I am taking all the variables to LHS part and all the constant parts to RHS. That is the method what I am going to use to solve the equations. Before going to solve next problems, I am going to tell you about transposing signs. That is, if there is plus on LHS, taking to RHS, it becomes negative. That is, addition becomes subtraction, and subtraction going to RHS become addition. Vice versa also. If negative is there, taking to LHS, it becomes addition. If addition is here, taking to LHS, it becomes subtraction. Now, remember, this is for addition and subtraction. What about the multiplication and division? If multiplication is here, then going to RHS it becomes division. That is, if a number is in the numerator, then going to RHS it goes to denominator. That is here division. Now if it is in denominator, that is division here itself, then going to RHS it becomes numerator. But remember, for multiplication and division, you can take the sign along with it. If it is a negative number here, taking to denominator, you can carry the negative also. But here, if it is negative in addition and subtraction, when going to RHS or the opposite side, you don't want to take the sign. You want to take the opposite sign of it. But here in multiplication and division, only thing is that you want to take the numerator part to denominator and denominator part to numerator along with the sign you can take. Okay? Don't want to change the signs in these two cases. Next example is one fraction type, that is 5x plus 7 by 2 equal to 3 by 2x minus 14. Here, I am going to transpose the variable parts and constant parts. So, it becomes 5x in LHS, taking this x term, that is 3 by 2x to LHS, it becomes minus 3 by 2x. I am taking the whole part. This is equal to, here already there is minus 14. Now, plus 7 by 2, taking to RHS, it becomes minus 7 by 2. Here, you can see, 1, 5x is the minus 3 by 2x is equal to minus 14 minus 7 by 2. Here, either we can multiply the whole equation with 2 to cancel these denominator 2s. That is, while we are multiplying with 2, remember, if you multiply a number in LHS, then you have to multiply it with RHS also. So, with 2, you are multiplying each and every term in this equation. So, 5x into 2 is 5 into 2. That is 10x. Don't forget this x to write here. 5 into 2 is 10 and x minus 3 by 2 into 2. X is the, before that, 3 by 2 into 2. 3 by 2 into 2 is 2 and 2 cancel because 1 is in numerator and 1 is in denominator. So, 2 and 2 cancel, balance will be 3x. This is why we multiplied with 2. To cancel this 2 in denominator, we multiplied with 2. So, the 2s are cancelled here. Now, equal to negative 14 into 2 is negative 28. Now, next is minus is the 7 by 2 into 2. 2 and 2 cancel, balance will be 7. Now, I got here 10x minus 3x is 7x. You can only add and subtract with same variable coefficients, okay? But you can't subtract 10x and 28 because in 28 there is no x. If there is an x, you have to do operations with same x term. Here 10x and 3x. So, you can subtract. That will be the answer 7x. Now, minus 28 minus 7. Both are constant. So, you can do the operation within them. Minus 28 minus 7. This becomes addition and sign changes. It is 35 and minus sign. Both were negatives. So, we get 7x equal to minus 35. Now, x is equal to, we need only the value of x. That is the solution of equation. Solution means finding the value of x. Now, x is equal to, here already minus 35 is there. Here this is 7x. 7x means 7 into x. Going to RHS, it becomes division 7. 35 division 7 is 5. And there is negative division positive. The result will be negative. So, we get the value x is equal to negative 5. This is one method. There is one more method to do this. That is, you don't want to multiply by 2 on both sides. But you have to find the LCM and make denominators same. How will you do it? Here there is 3 by 2x and here 5x. Now 5x simply means 5x by 1. So you have to cross multiply and make it as a single denominator. 5x into 2 is 10x. This numerator into this denominator. Here there is a subtraction. 3x into 1 is 3x. Now whole divided by product of two denominators. 1 into 2 is 2 is equal to. Again here you can't subtract this 14 and 7 because this is a fraction and this is a whole number. So you want to make this as fraction. 14 simply means 14 by 1. Now cross multiply. 14 2s are, that is minus 14 into 2 is minus 28. Now subtraction is the 7 1s are 7. Whole division denominators product, that is 2. 10x minus 3x is 7x. Is equal to, keep this 2 here, minus 28 minus 7 is plus minus, that is minus 35 by 2 is the. I need only x, right? So I am keeping this x here in LHS. Here there is minus 35 by 2. I told you before, whatever number is in numerator going to RHS, it becomes denominator. So 7 goes to denominator. 7 going to denominator. Here already we have a 2. This 7 going to denominator, it becomes 2 into 7. The 7 is from LHS. Now we have a 2 here in denominator. I need only the value of x. So taking this 2 to RHS, it goes to numerator. Numerator we have a 35. It goes to that is into 2. X is equal to, now 2 in numerator and 2 in denominator cancel. 35 by 7, the answer is 5. 1 negative and positive is in denominator. So negative by positive is negative. This is another method. In the previous method, we multiplied the whole equation with 2 and cancelled this denominator. In this method, I cross multiplied and make a whole denominators and then taking all the constants and coefficient to RHS and keeping the variable part here in LHS, I got the answer negative 5. In the previous type also, I got the answer negative 5. Both you can use. Next, let us solve exercise 2.3. Solve the following equations and check your results. First question is 3x is equal to 2x plus 18. I am using transposing method. So taking all the variable part to LHS, 3x, 2x coming to LHS become minus 2x. This is equal to, 18 is already in RHS. 3 minus 2 is 1. 1x is equal to 18. That is, x is equal to 18. I have solved the equation. Now you want to verify it. That is, I want to substitute it in the question and check whether it is right. 3 into 18. That is, verifying it. 3x means 3 into 18. 3 into 18 is 54. This is equal to, here x is 18, so 2 into 18 plus 18. 2 into 18 is 36 plus 18 is 54. Yes, LHS is equal to RHS, so verify. Here we get, after substituting in LHS and RHS, we get both LHS and RHS are equal. If our answer was wrong, then we will get both are not equal. Here both are equal, so our answer is right. Hence verified. Now next, 5t minus 3 is equal to 3t minus 5. Taking all the t terms to LHS, 5t minus 3t. 3t coming to LHS becomes minus 3t. Now already minus 5 in RHS. This minus 3 going to RHS become positive 3. That is addition. Now 5 minus 3 is 2t is equal to minus 5 plus 3. Opposite sign. So subtract 3 from 5 and put 5 sign, that is negative 2. Now t, we need only the value of t. So here it is already minus 2. Taking this 2 from 2 into t to RHS, it goes to denominator. Now 2 by 2 is 1. This is negative and this is positive. So answer will be negative 1. Now if you want, you can verify. 5t, you have to verify in this, in the question. That is 5 into negative 1 is negative 5. Negative 5 minus 3 is negative 5 minus 3 become negative 5 plus minus 3. This is equal to 3 into negative 1. 3t means 3 into negative 1 is negative 3. Here minus 5. This become plus minus. Now minus 5 plus minus 3 is 8. Minus 3 plus minus 5 is minus 8. So both sides we get negative 8. So LHS is equal to RHS. Hence verified our result. 5x plus 9 is equal to 5 plus 3x. Now taking 3x to LHS, 5x minus 3x is equal to 5 already in RHS, taking 9 to RHS minus 9. 5 minus 3 is 2x is equal to 5 minus 9 become plus and minus. That is minus 4 is the answer. X is equal to negative 4. Here 2 into x, so going to RHS it becomes division 2. Negative 4 by 2, division 2 is equal to negative 2. Here 1 negative and 1 positive, so the result will be negative. Negative 2 is the answer. Verifying, we get 5 into negative 2. 5x means 5 into negative 2 is negative 10 plus 9 in LHS. Now 5 plus 3 into x. 3x means 3 into negative 2, that is minus 6. Minus 10 plus 9 is minus 1 is equal to 5 plus minus 6 is minus 1. LHS is equal to RHS, hence verified. 4z plus 3 is equal to 6 plus 2z. Here 4z in LHS, this 2h from RHS coming to LHS, transposing you will get minus 2z is equal to 6 is already in RHS, 3 taken to RHS it becomes minus 3. 4 minus 2, 2 is the answer. Now z is the variable here. 6 minus 3 is 3. Z is equal to 3 here into 2. So going to RHS it becomes division 2. 3 by 2 is the answer. Now we have to substitute this in each z. So this becomes 4z means 4 into 3 by 2 plus 3 is equal to 6 plus 2 into 2z means 2 into 3 by 2. Now 4 into 3 by 2. Here 1 2s are 2 and in 4 2 2s. We have 2 as the common factor in 4 and 2. So 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4. In the numerator part it is 2 into 3. Here it becomes 6 plus 3 here. Now here in numerator and denominator you have 2s. So you can cancel it. That is 2 1s are 2 and 2 1s are 2. 1 into 3 is 3. Now 6 is here plus 1 3s are 3. 6 plus 3, 9. 6 plus 3, 9. LHS is equal to RHS. Verified. Next, 2x minus 1 is equal to 14 minus x. Here, taking x to LHS plus x equal to 14 is here. Minus 1 to RHS plus 1. 2x plus x is 3x equal to 14 plus 1 is 15. Now 3 into x, keep this x here, taking 3 to RHS it becomes by 3. 15 division 3 is 5, or you can cut it with common factor, that is 3 is a common factor. 3 1s are 3 and 3 5s are 15. So x is equal to 5 by 1 means 5. Now you have to verify. 2 into x means 2 into 5, 10. Minus 1 is equal to 14 minus, here x is 5. 10 minus 1 is 9, is equal to 14 minus 5 is also 9. LHS is equal to RHS. Next, 8x plus 4 is equal to 3 into x minus 1 plus 7. Here, keep this 8x plus 4 in LHS. You can see a bracket here. First, you have to distribute it. Then only you can transpose the terms. Here 3 into x is 3x minus 3 into 1 is 3 plus 7. Now no need of bracket. We have already opened it. 3 into x minus 1 becomes 3x minus 3 plus 7 is here. Now taking all the x variables to LHS, 8x, 3x coming to LHS minus 3x is equal to minus 3 already in RHS plus 7 already in RHS. Taking this plus 4 to RHS it becomes minus 4. Now 8 minus 3 is 5x here in LHS. Now negative 3 plus 7. First you have to add it, and to that result you can subtract 4. So minus 3 plus 4, the result is plus 4, because Here it is negative and this is positive. Subtract smaller number from bigger number and put bigger number sign. So it becomes 4. Now there is minus 4. 4 minus 4 is 0. Now x is equal to 0 on RHS. Taking this 5 to RHS, it becomes by 5. 0 by any value, the result will be 0. So we get x is equal to 0. Now you have to verify it. I will substitute it in the question. 8x means 8 into 0. 8 into 0 is 0 plus 4 is there, is equal to 3 into 0 minus 1. Here x minus 1 becomes 0 minus 1. 0 minus 1 is minus 1 plus 7. Now 0 plus 4 is 4. 3 into minus 1 minus 3 plus 7. Minus 3 plus 7 is, result is positive 4. LHS is equal to RHS, hence verified. Next question, x is equal to 4 by 5 into x plus 10. There is a bracket here, so first you have to open it. Either you can open it or there is another method, I will show it later. Here it becomes 4 by 5 into x is 4 by 5 x plus 4 by 5 into 10. 4 by 5 into 10, that is opening this. Here 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, and then in numerator part, denominator is 1, so no need of writing it. Here in numerator, 4 into 2, 8 is here. Now taking this variable part here, x minus 4 by 5 x is equal to 8 here in RHS. Here you want to cross multiply, that is x into 5 is 5x minus 4 into 1 is 4x whole by 1 into 5, that is denominator's product. 5 is equal to 8. 5x minus 4x is 1x in numerator. By 5, taking to RHS, it goes to numerator. That is 8 into 5. That is 1x means x is equal to 8. 5s are 40. This is the solution. I will show you one more method. 40 was the solution. Now here, if this is a whole into bracket, and no other terms here. If there is another term along with this, then you can't take this 4 by 5. Since there is no term and a single term with bracket and whole into 4 by 5, you can take this 4 by 5 directly to LHS. If there was another term here, you can't take it. If the bracket is closed here and having another term here, you can't take this 4 by 5 directly to RHS. You have to open this and find the solution. But here, since there is no term other than this, we can directly take this 4 by 5 to LHS. Here, 5 is in the denominator, going to LHS, it becomes numerator. 4 here in numerator, so coming to LHS, it becomes denominator, is equal to x plus 10 is here. Taking this x to here, minus x, equal to 10. Now here there is 1, cross multiplying you will get 5x into 1 is 5x minus 4 into x is 4x by 1, 4s are 4 equal to 10. Here this is whole division 4, then you can take this to RHS. If the denominator was only for one term, you can't take this. Here this is whole by 4 because product of two denominators is whole by, so you can take this to RHS. That is 5x minus 4x in numerator, you will get x. There is a 4 in denominator, we are taking it to RHS, it becomes 10 into 4, that is 40. Previous method also we get the result 40. So the solution of x is 40. Let us substitute here in the question and check whether it is right. X is 40 in LHS. Here let us check, 4 by 5 into this become 40 plus 10. Now in RHS, 4 by 5 is the 40 plus 10 is 50. Now 5 and 50, you can divide it. 5 and 50, this is 10. That is 5 ones are 5 and 10 5s are 50. 5 is the common factor. 5 ones are 5, 5 tens are 50. Now 4 into 10. In LHS there is 40. Here in RHS, 4 into 10 is again 40. LHS is equal to RHS, so verified. Next, 2x by 3 plus 1 is equal to 7x by 15 plus 3. I am taking the x variables to one side. So 2x by 3 in LHS, taking this variable part to LHS, it becomes minus 7x by 15. This is equal to 3 already in RHS, taking plus 1 to the minus 1. Here there are different denominators. So either you can cross multiply it. Since here we have a composite number, we can find the LCM by factorizing method. That is 3 and 15. 3 is a common factor. 3 ones are 3 and 3 fives are 15. Now in 1 and 5, we have to continue this till we get 1 here. So here there is a 5. So factorizing with 5, we get 1, and taking down this 1 here, in 5, 5 one time. So we get 1 and 1 here. So stop. Consider this and their product. That is the LCM. LCM is equal to 3 into 5. 15 is the LCM. Now you have to change each denominator to 15. Here this is already 15, so no change in this fraction. But here it is 3, so you have to make it as 15. So 3 into what is 15? 15 is our LCM. 3 into 5 is 15. LCM is 15. 3 into 5 is 15. So whatever you do in the denominator, you have to multiply it with numerator also. So here also into 5. Now this term becomes 2x into 5 is 10x, that is 2 5s are 10 and this x, by 5 3s are 15. Here don't want to change anything because already there is 15, that is the LCM. Now 7x by 15 is equal to 3 minus 1 is 2. Now both are 15, so you can subtract this directly. 10x minus 7x is 3x, and take down the denominator. 3x by 15 is equal to 2. Now in 3 and 15, you have 3 as the common factor. In numerator and denominator, you can cut with common factor. So 3 ones are 3, 3 fives are 15. This becomes 1x by 5. 1x by 5 is equal to 2. 2 already in RHS. Now we need only the value of x. So take this 5 from denominator to RHS, it goes to numerator. That is x is equal to 2 into 5. 2 fives are 10. We get the value x is equal to 10. Now let us check it. Let us verify it in the question. This becomes 2 by 3, 2 into 10 plus 1 equal to 7 into 10 by 15 plus 3. Now 2 tens are 20 by 3 plus 1 equal to, here in 10 and 15 we have 5 as the factor. So 5 2s are 10 and 5 3s are 15. So 7 2s are 14 by 3 is here. Now plus 3. Here in this term we find in 10 and 15 5 is the factor. So I cut with 5 in both numerator and denominator, I get 2 and 3. So 7 2s are 14 and by 3 plus 3 is here. Now 20 by 3 plus 1 is equal to 14 by 3 plus 3. We want to check whether LHS and RHS are equal. Here 1 means 1 by 1 and here 3 by 1. Now cross multiplying, 20 into 1 is 20 plus 1 3s are 3 by 3. That is product of denominator is equal to 14 ones are 14 plus 3 3s are 9 by 3 ones are 3. 20 plus 3 is 23 by 3 is equal to 14 plus 9 is 23 by 3. We got LHS is equal to RHS, hence verified that value of x is 10. That was our solution, x is equal to 10. Next, 2y plus 5 by 3 is equal to 26 by 3 minus y. Now taking y to LHS, 2y minus y coming to LHS become plus y. This is equal to 26 by 3, taking 5 by 3 to RHS, minus 5 by 3. Here 2y plus 1y is 3y. Here both denominators are same, so don't want to cross multiply or don't want to find the LCM. We are doing the cross multiplication and finding the LCM to make the denominator same. Here already it is same, so you can directly do it. 26 minus 5 is 21 by 3. 3y is equal to 21 division 3. In 21 and 3, you have 3 as the common factor. So 3 7s are 21, 3 1s are 3. 7 by 1, 7 is the answer. Now we need only the value of y. So keep this y here in LHS. This is into 3. So coming to RHS, it becomes by 3. 7 by 3 is the value of y. Let us verify it. 7 by 3. Here it becomes 2 into 7 by 3 plus 5 by 3 is equal to 26 by 3 minus 7 by 3. Here 2 sevens are 14 by 3 plus 5 by 3 equal to 26 by 3 minus 7 by 3. In LHS, both denominators are same. So 14 plus 5 is 19 by 3. This is equal to RHS also denominators are same. So you can directly subtract it. 26 minus 7 is 19 by 3. Both LHS and RHS are equal. So verified our result 7 by 3. Next, 3M is equal to 5M minus 8 by 5. Here, take this 5M to LHS, become minus 5M is equal to minus 8 by 5. 3M minus 5M, 3 minus 5, that is plus minus, answer will be minus 2. So it becomes minus 2M, don't forget to write the M, equal to minus 8 by 5. Now here it is into, so coming to RHS it becomes denominator. So I told you before, you can take the sign along with the number while you are taking to denominator. So keep this M here, minus 8 is here, 5 into this minus 2 going to denominator becomes 5 into minus 2, which is equal to M is equal to minus 8 by minus 10. Minus 8 by minus 10. The result is negative and negative, the result will be positive. Here in 8 and 10, 2 is a common factor. 2 4s are 8 and 2 into what is 10? 2 5s are 10. So positive 4 by 5 is the value of M. Let us check it. LHS and RHS. 4 by 5. 3 into 4 by 5. M means 4 by 5. Now this is 5 into 4 by 5 minus 8 by 5. Here 4 3s are 12 by 5. This is equal to, here it becomes 5 4s are 20 by 5 minus 8 by 5. That is 12 by 5 is equal to 20. Here both are 5, so you can directly subtract. 20 minus 8 is 12 by 5. Here we get LHS equal to RHS. So our answer is verified. Our solution was 4 by 5.